laboratories, we are working to put the ravages of nuclear Armageddon forever in the past. With your grant dollars, we are completing work on a revolutionary program of genetic therapy. In the future, you and your families will be made immune to all forms of lethal radiation. Peace-loving civilizations will enjoy the benefits of a limited thermonuclear confrontation. Fear of fallout will be forgotten. A well-aimed strike at less desirable parts of our cities can reduce the crime rate by as much as 20%. Past studies have shown that garbage and human waste combust instantaneously and that unsightly graffiti disappears altogether from monuments and buildings. What better way to test the structural soundness of our public schools? With your research dollars, Tinman Laboratories can help millions enjoy their golden years in an uncertain radioactive future. We must choose hope and confidence in our future or face certain annihilation.
Well, gentlemen, I hope this answers most of your questions about what we've been doing and what we hope to continue to do when you give us this next grant.
Tinman, I certainly enjoyed your film, but I can't seem to find any test results in your proposals here.
We haven't quite gotten that far yet.
Any patients?
Not quite yet.
I see. Any experiments on animals?
They're on order.
Well, how about a look at the laboratory?
It's not quite ready. They're still painting.
No laboratory?
No laboratory.
How about notes? At least you've got some notes.
Well, there is... No, I guess that doesn't really count.
Well, you certainly don't mean to say that you've spent the entire $1.5 million just on this film.
They give me three months to come up with something big, and they cut the funds.
Relax, Oscar.
There's no money in university research. Radiation studies is a dead end.
This is gonna work.
I should have known. I mean, used to be, show them a movie, take them out for a drink, boom, the check's in the mail. Now, they want results.
Listen, Oscar, the university's gonna be so impressed they'll give you an honorary degree.
Yes, but will they give me money?
Of course they will. Don't forget, you promised to pull those strings for us out west.
I'll give you anything you want. Just get me a subject. He's gotta be gullible, desperate enough to try anything hopeless.
I still don't get it. You mean this operation that you're talking about is going to make me immune to all sorts of radiation?
That's right, Steve. What's the vegetarian entree today?
Bread puree.
Well, you'll have some of that, and some fried bread to go with it.
Rolls, too?
Sure, why not? You see, Steve, when the bomb drops, while everybody else is looking like this, you'll be able to prance around as if nothing had happened. And who knows, with that mad bomber on the loose, he just might go nuclear any day.
You still gotta get him to sign the release for the operation.
And not only that, but you'll become stronger and more intelligent. You will be genetically superior in every way.
I didn't know I was gonna do all those things.
What? Most importantly, you will be part of a grander scheme. If the operation is a success, Dr. Dirchfall will be able to complete the final part of the plan.
The what?
Not the what, Steve.
The plans.
It is true what they say about it, isn't it, Oscar?
Oh, that's right, Tom.
No, I'm John. He's Tom. I'm John Thompson, and he's Tom Johnson.
Oh, John. Quite frankly, it's going to revolutionize the world.
Again, you win. That is to be making 44 times.
You're too much this smart for me, Sonia. Do we play again?
Play again? Vladimir, is 44 times not enough for you? I will tell you. If I am to see one more time Colonel Mustard screaming, I will do.
Oh, you are just poor loser, Ivan.
I'm not poor loser. I am bald. That is Boris. Maybe some. Is music I hear? Maybe some news at last.
Boris will come.
Tremendous idea I'm just having.
What is it, Vladimir?
Why do we not play chess?
We do not play chess. Yeah. Russians play chess. We are Americans. Oh. Understand? We are to be dressing, eating, and talking like Americans. No one should be knowing that Sonia, Ivan, and Vladimir are not Yoka locals from Charlottesville, Virginia.
Charlottesville, Virginia. What is here? Why not New York? Why not Washington, D.C.? Is some spying in Cleveland? In Los Angeles, is Malibu racetracks? Is movie stars? What is here?
Is safety haven for nuclear war?
Is boring.
No, Oscar, I don't think I've ever heard of Dr. Dirchfall.
Well, Steve, Dr. Dirchfall only happens to be the leading figure in the field of genetic mutation due to nuclear fallout.
Huh? Just take a look.
We're talking worldwide reputation.
The good doctor doesn't seem to be here. We had to double up on space since the mad bomber hit our mainland. Oh, there's Dr. Dirchfall now. Dr. Dirchfall?
Yes?
Dr. Dirchfall, this is Steve Austin.
Oh, hello.
Did you lose something?
Yes, I lost this part of my hat, and I'm so disappointed. It's my favorite hat. Oh, so you're the one I've heard so much about.
He's the one, Doctor.
I hope you realize the historical significance of my work, Steve.
We're in the midst of a genetic breakthrough, Steve, and you're going to lead us into the next generation.
Really? Isn't it amazing how far we've advanced, Steve?
Okay, so maybe it doesn't work today, but we can fix it tomorrow, and soon we won't need them at all. Soon we won't have buildings with elevators, just the whole floor will move.
And then there won't be any floors. Buildings will be one big round ball.
And television will show four movies all at the same time.
And you cook eggs and cheeseburgers on the screen, and it'll make ice cream in the back.
Come on, Steve, what flavor do you want?
Just think, Steve. If this operation is a success, the potential for genetic engineering would be limitless.
We are on the verge of great things, Steve.
We could become a nation of supermen. Hey,
better make sure this is the right stuff.
Is everything set? Everything's fine.
Terrific!
The out?
Like a light.
Like a light? No thanks, I don't smoke.
All right, who ordered the mushroom and cheese?
I did.
My skin is falling off! I'm dying!
Let's hope it doesn't turn out like I lost it! Let's hope it doesn't turn out like I lost it!
I need any help, ma'am?
No, thank you. I'm not going to buy anything.
Oh, just looking for Christmas ideas.
Oh, you see, I'm here to turn that puppet into a real live boy.
Come on, Steve. The operation was the easy part. You gotta wanna be stronger. You gotta throw those crutches away and walk on your own. Come on, that's it. First throw a left jab, then shoot a straight right, come back with the left hook. Boom, be down in a second. Work in, champ.
Always getting the negative and the positive mixed up. Huh. Wow.
He's made some amazing progress, hasn't he, Doctor?
Oh, yes. I'd say all we have to do is work out some more bugs, and then he'll be all set. It's when the wires cross in his right arm, it creates a radio.
How am I doing, Oscar?
Oh, you're getting better and better every day, Steve. Careful with those pills, Steve. You know, your body chemistry has been modified to accept them. But if someone else were to take them, it would knock them cold.
You know, believe me. Here. One for you. One for you. Any further questions?
I'm going to turn it on now. Sit down, Steve.
High right around 40. We
is that radio acting up again? Well, give your arm a little tap. With anything. Like this. From the album. Just as simple as that. Boy, will I be glad when you meet my Alice.
Alice?
Yes, and my work will be finished.
You see, Steve, the world will never be the same once the plan go into effect. This doesn't end with your operation. Man of the future must mate the woman of the future. And that's what Alice is going to be once we operate on her, too.
Then you can have babies and babies and more babies.
You know, Steve, I really envy you. That Alice is a hot little number. I've always thought that she took her beauty from her mother.
Oh, get it out of here. Well, I sure hate to give up my little Alice. So Pollard said, lucky for you, I am to be opening door, or you are not to be getting any points.
So fun you are having, I see.
Play, play, play.
So, Boris, we are glad you are finally being calm.
It's Bob.
What?
Bob. My name is. All time you are calling to me Boris, but it's Bob. B-O-B. Okay? It's Bob.
All right, Boris.
Bob! Enough, enough, enough. Tell us now, Boris. Bob, what are you to be finding out, huh?
A day it was. Well, some people are playing. History I make. They are being here.
What are being here?
The plans.
Are you to being sure? Who has them?
Dr. Dershowitz.
How are we to be getting to her?
Steve Olson.
Anti-radiation man of Dr. Dershowitz. To Steve Olson and the plan.
Maria? Hey, I brought you your lunch. You forgot it this morning. Well, I'll just put it over here. Hey, you need any help down there?
Steve, where were you last night? You said you'd be home at 10. You weren't home until 3 in the morning.
I had things to do.
You always have things to do. What about me?
Well, you have things to do, too. I understand.
Yeah, like work to support the both of us, then go home and cook dinner.
Yeah, well, that's a problem when both members of the household work.
But you don't work.
I go to school.
You've been in college now for 7 years, and you're still nowhere near graduating.
And you don't think that's tough to do?
Steve, just leave me alone.
Look. Maria, I'll make it up to you somehow, I promise.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce to the public someone of whom I am very proud, Steve Olson.
Tell us, Steve, just what exactly is it like to be genetically superior?
Well, that's great. Although, with all these wires inside of me, I am beginning to feel a little bit attracted to calculators.
We love Steve! We love Steve! We love Steve!
Just who is this Steve Awesome? Although really very little is known about him by this reporter, he seems to have captured the fancy of the American public. Consequently, we decided to ask a few typical Americans what they think of this new man.
Steve? Great guy. Love him. Come up here and party anytime. Anytime.
Well, he seems like a nice boy.
I like his hair.
I hope he can get rid of this terrible mad bummer.
Steve Awesome is perhaps the most important person of this century, notwithstanding his calculator fetish.
Any friend of the calculator is a friend of mine.
What's a calculator?
Obviously, there's a latent desire here he's repressing.
I just hope his feeling toward calculators won't turn him away from God.
Do calculators have anything to do with homosexuals?
There's certainly something in the Bible about homosexuals.
There's certainly something about the Bible and Freud.
Does anybody know when the next bus comes?
But Cinderella, you have to go to the ballroom.
Look, lady, like I'm really getting tired of you, you know? Can't you understand? Me and my man just want to stay here tonight, watch some love walk, kind of do some of that stuff ourselves, you understand? Now get out of here!
Well, I've already turned your pumpkin into a coach, and I have your glass slippers waiting.
Look, lady.
What is going on out here? Sonia, how to spell MX?
So, to sum up and conclude today's lecture, in a nuclear war between the U.S. and Russia, the winner would be decided not only by who had first strike and who had retaliatory capability.
It's nice to know where long-range missiles are to be located, yes?
Yes.
Kansas, Wyoming, Idaho, and Pismo Beach.
Tonic capabilities of the ICBM, Titan, and Polaris versus the backfire.
It's also nice to know test is choice multiple, false, true, or leave.
Test? When is test?
Who decided to use MIRVs and who went with satellites would weigh as heavily as dense packed modes and armed submarines.
So, you're certainly a hit and run driver.
Well,
what are you talking about?
I'm talking about last week, or have you already forgotten? I mean, what is this? A few games of tennis and a quick roll in the hay? I never hear from you again? I mean, Tom told me you were great, but he didn't say you were heartless, too.
But by hardware as well. And there are still more questions.
I don't know about these people from the foreign exchange program.
So anyway, getting back to the joke, the guy picks up a hitchhiker, and it's a Polak.
Yeah?
I'm here to see Mr. Tinman.
I am not.
If you just give me 3 weeks,
I will not give you 3 weeks.
It sounds like he's in a meeting now.
My wife was just put in the hospital the other day.
You're breaking my heart.
Well,
I have almost all your money.
Fine, I want it all.
I'll just sit over here.
Good. Give me all of it.
Thank you.
I want it now.
It's a problem. If you gave me 2 weeks,
you do not understand me. I am attempting to say something to you. I will not give you 2 seconds.
A week.
No.
Give you 3 days.
No.
I have a deal in the works right now. I can give you twice what you lend.
I want what you owe me now. I want it now. I want it immediately. I want it in cash or in some legal tender from you.
How about if I give? I got 70% of
it. I want
I
all of
it. With me right now.
No. 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 No.
Nancy, could you have somebody come and clean up this mess? Come here, Steve. Oh, Nancy, this is rather important, so hold all my incoming calls.
Pleased to be being excused, but my name is Natasha, not Nancy.
and you are to be having no clothes for 3 days now.
Oh. Well, in that case, let him come through.
Have a seat, Steve.
It's too bad he didn't read our most recent memo on late payments. So, how are you doing, Steve?
Well, gee, Oscar, I really don't feel like I'm getting any stronger.
Oh, sure you are, sure you are. You been taking any pills? Oh, come on, I'll show you. Come on. Come on. So, you all set for my spring Halloween party this weekend? I've invited someone that you will be especially interested in meeting.
Who's that?
Why, your future mate.
Alice?
So, buddies, what you got, huh?
How many times I am to be telling you, Ivan? My name is Bob, not Boris. You are to be calling to me Bob now, yes?
All right, Bob. Now tell us, Bob, what is it that you did find out?
There is to be. There is to be costume party on weekend. Oscar is to be taking Steve Awesome to meet Dr. Dursfall's daughter. Oscar is telling me to come and to bring many friends.
Ah, so we will go to party.
Yes, Sonia.
Wait a minute, I have to be knowing something. It's party one and we are not knowing nobody and we have to be sitting by ourselves and drinking too much. You know I hate parties like that.
It's enough, Ivan.
As I am seeing it!
What is it that you are saying?
I am saying, as I am seeing it, I can't hear you. All I hear is music, I tell you. I can't hear a thing except that music. What? This music is leaving me like my life. Where is it coming from?
Wait a second!
What?
You're upside down! Sorry, I'm a bit late.
You're an hour and a half late. It's burned.
Well, let's just put something in the microwave.
You know I'd hate to use that.
Look, Oscar didn't give it to us just to use as a bookend. Don't be so old-fashioned.
It's just because of the cab. Your stupid nephew.
Oh, come on. He's only six. It was raining outside. He just wanted to warm the cat up a little. That's all. Look.
Things haven't been the same since my operation. What's wrong?
Everything's different now, that's all.
Things change. You've got to move forward.
Do you remember how we first met? I didn't know you from one of the squirrels climbing in the trees. So you took my car and put it up on blocks. I cried and cried until you took it back down again.
Well, I had to get your attention somehow. I hate it when we fight. Okay, so maybe I have been a bit unreasonable.
Thinks it's for the best. I'll still live here. I've got an image to protect. The other place is just a front. I'm a public figure now. I can't have 5-year-olds thinking it's okay to sleep with whoever you want. Yeah, well, maybe I have. My intelligence has gone up 10%. Maybe that's enough for me to realize how stupid I've been for 3 years.
Get out.
I am. I'm getting out.
Damn, him. I am having no idea where we are.
Where is the dress, boys?
It's Bob.
Oh. Where is the dress, boys?
Is he Bob?
Oh. Boris, where is it?
No, Boris, I'm Sonia.
Oh, no. Bob, Ivan, Sonia. Where is Boris? They're to be losing Boris! His best friend of mine!
Shut up, Vladimir! Here is the dress.
Thank you, Boris.
Close enough. Come.
Shit, why ain't looking there? Bears over there.
Damn, Wayne, now the hippies must be serious about arming bears.
Dangerous trend, Wayne. That's why I drink.
We're here from WAGM-TV. Hey, you wouldn't mind doing a quick interview now, would you?
Oh, well, I do have to go to this party.
Oh, sure, sure. You know, Steve, the people in our viewing audience are just dying to find out more about you, especially what the real Steve Awesome is like. And we thought, hey, what better way to find out about the real Steve Awesome than when he least expected it? Oh, I almost forgot. This is Dr. Schrumpfen. He's a psychologist. He's here to comment on the effects of your operation.
Psst. Ivan. Any sign of Dr. Durstfall yet?
I'm not to know. You see, I am having such wonderful time.
You have to be being patient. Durstfall will come.
Okay, Steve. Just how does it feel to be genetically superior?
Well, gee, I don't know. Sometimes it's really great, and other times, well, I almost wish I was someone else, a little more normal.
I don't mean to make comparisons, but schizophrenics often say that in the early stages.
I mean to be so strong. When I was a kid, I used to dream of being able to run faster than any man alive, and now...
Well, of course, childhood fantasies are often indicative of repressed desire.
I've just got a great stereo. You ought to take a look at it. It's up in my bedroom.
You don't like the bedroom? I've got this great clock radio in the kitchen.
Now, Steve, we want to reunite you with someone right here on TV. Someone who means a great deal to you, and someone whose circumstances have prevented you from seeing for some time now.
Who's that?
A repressed memory.
Why, Steve, it's your mother!
Oh, but my mother can't be here. She's in Hong Kong.
Denying his mother's existence? A sure sign of guilt.
Oh, Steve. Now, I know you've blocked her out of your mind all these years, but Steve, think of the camps.
I never went to camp.
No, Steve. I meant the refugee camps. But the past doesn't matter anymore because we've got her right here.
Steve, darling. Oh, darling. Oh, Steve, you're wonderful.
Steve,
oh,
is
so
that any way to treat your mother?
Guilt resurfacing.
Oh, darling,
I've never seen this woman before in my life.
Oh, death wish. It will come.
Now, we all know how time can change appearances.
Lost sex.
Say, we're supposed to be scarecrow or something?
Oh, no, nothing like that. You see, I couldn't decide what
way. Well, just get yourself a drink.
Oh, Steve, how you doing? Don't get up. Say, what are you dressed as anyway?
Oh, well, you know, I couldn't decide.
Hey, anyway, I want you to stay close by because you know who may be here. Soo-hoo-hoo.
Well, Steve, tonight's the big night. Alice just got here.
I've been meaning to talk to you about that, Oscar.
Now you're going to be so excited when you see him.
Well, I'm sure I'd be just as happy if you just gave me one of those inflatable dolls and I could just go home right now.
Oh, nonsense.
Hi, Steve. Alice was just here a minute ago.
Oh, well, that's all right. I understand if she can't make it.
She'll be right back, I'm sure.
Yeah. Well, Doctor, you must be relieved to know that your Alice is in such good hands with Steve.
Steve, I have a secret to tell you. Alice is my favorite of all my six children. She is the only one that isn't mentally retarded.
I wonder, what they really are.
Not what are.
You know, the...
Oh, that must be her now. Children are so funny.
Yes, they are. So amusing.
I thought that kind of beauty went out with Helen of Troy.
Oh, no. She'll go out with anybody.
Oh, God, we better stop. My mother might get the wrong impression of you.
don't believe we've been properly introduced. My name's Austin. Steve Austin.
Excuse me, I must have slipped.
It's about 1:45 p.m. in the afternoon. Our next tune goes out to that crazy guy. The man bomber's got the whole town upside down.
Hello, Alice. Hello, Alice.
Hello, Alice. Hello, Alice. Hello, Alice. Hello, Alice.
Hello there, Steve. Oh, don't tell me you've forgotten who I am already. Steve, you don't look happy to see us again.
I'm not.
Well, you should be grateful. Our last report was such a big hit, they've asked me to do a follow-up. And this time, we're live. Nationally. And we've brought you another somebody you haven't seen in years.
Not my mother again.
Oh, no, Steve, not this time. But someone else you were very close to at one time. Steve, it's your old high school girlfriend.
Oh, my God, Lisa.
I'm sorry, Steve. I couldn't make it to the prom, but I really did have to wash my hair.
Alice, this is your mother. Steve's here.
Oh, shit. Mom, just a second. Don't come in. I'm not dressed yet.
I'm your mother. I've dressed you 1,000 times.
I know, and I'm embarrassed about it, too, Mom. Whose is this?
I don't think it's mine.
She's so funny. She had a girlfriend stay over last night, and she don't want me to know. Children like to keep things from their parents. I guess you do too, Steve.
Terrific. Ma, I'll be just a second, Mom. Quick, out the window.
I remember when I was Alice's age. We had slumber parties every weekend. Things haven't changed. Parents aren't as dumb as you think they are, Steve. I thought I heard you talking to someone in there.
No, it was the radio.
Well, I guess you two want to get going. See ya.
Seven foot four, see the kids you.
aboard.
Hey, would you like to go eat? I know this wonderful restaurant. They've got great seafood there.
I think I'll have the Mort du Charlie. And how about you? She'll have the same. Well, this place certainly has changed since the last time I was here. Ah, well, things change.
I hope Vladimir has lunch ready for us when we are getting back.
I hope Vladimir has not eaten our lunch when we are getting back.
Shut up, Ivan.
Say, I know this really funny joke. This guy, he's driving this really nice car, right? And he stops to pick up this Polish hitchhiker.
If I hadn't opened my door, you wouldn't have gotten any points.
What's that?
The punchline. If I hadn't opened my door, you wouldn't have gotten any points.
All right. Oh, well, you certainly can't beat the service here, can you?
Mm-mm.
Well, dig in.
Very good. Very good.
Well, I don't know about you, but I sure am having a good time.
The Apocalypse of John.
Where's that sound coming from?
The word apocalypse means the unveiling.
You know, I don't know.
The book of Revelation was an unveiling.
Let me go find out.
An open book written to be understood, but not understood by all.
We are to kidnap her now, yes?
Yes, and once we are having Dr. Durstfall's daughter, we are also to be having...
plans.
Let's go.
He saw angels in the sky and a great red
Get him!
I don't know who you people are, but I do know this is strictly against the law. And when my lawyer gets in touch with your lawyer regarding a certain suit over a certain blow to my head, you are going to find yourselves talking your way out of a big financial loss. And I do mean megabucks. Capiche?
Is this English?
Go ahead, play super dumb with me. But just remember, ignorance is 9/10 of the law.
Enough playing. We are wanting them, and we are wanting them now.
Want what?
The
plants?
Yes, we are wanting them, and we are wanting them now.
Get lost, bozo.
It's Bob!
Come on, boys. Time is to being on our side. There be many ways of getting to her brain.
Huh?
We could torture her.
We could brainwash her.
Or we could just cut out her brain.
Oh.
Of course, that would permanently disfigure her face.
Oh.
Steve, Jones.
So, Steve, what year are you in high school?
Huh?
Engineering, right? After all, this is returning for engineering students.
Oh, yeah, of course, I wasn't thinking.
So, what do you think of the girls around here?
Oh, they're okay, I guess.
They're robots. When we couldn't get any real girls to come here, we decided... Who needs them anyway? So we built our own. Not bad, huh?
I was looking for this girl named Alice.
You see, they're all named Alice. Oh, whatever you want.
Having a good time.
Just as long as I'm not.
I was looking for this girl named Alice. I was looking for Alice.
It's so hot. It's a long way. It's very far.
Got it, eh?
All right.
It's good.
Chips.
Good
chips, huh? Twinkies? Macaroni and cheese, huh? Cigarettes, Ivan.
Thank you. Cigarette, thank you. It's good.
And for Vladimir, donuts, huh?
Thank you, boys.
And vodka. Where is vodka?
Vodka is slipping down and breaking on the way home.
Oh, Boris! But is there no problem? We'll go and get some more. Eh?
No, Boris. You will be staying here this time. We will go out and get vodka.
I can.
You will stay here and watch girl. Yes.
Do svidaniya.
Watch girl.
Yes? Plumber, I'm here to fix your pipe. You got a leaky pipe. I'm gonna fix it for you.
All right, is Paul coming in?
Thank you, sir.
I'm here to rescue you. Oh. I'm gonna get you out of here.
But how did you ever find me? Who are you?
Russian to me.
Where's Boris? Boris!
Oh, just, it'll be okay.
I mean, I don't even know this guy's name.
I think it's Boris.
He's Bob.
Thanks.
Boris, здравствуйте.
The sandwiches to you, too.
Here, buddies. Have a drink.
Hey! It's not Boris. Boris always drinks right-handed. Must be Bob.
It's not Bob. It's Impostor.
He's all American boy.
Don't worry. I'll get us out of here. Oh, please don't be upset.
Upset? How can I not be upset? I'm trapped in this dingy little room with only a few hours left to live. In this bed.
Now, come on. Did you really expect me to play Scrabble?
But they told me all good fairies come here.
Give to me vodka, Bob.
His Boris.
Do you realize that tomorrow we will be being the most powerful men on earth? Huh?
Paris will be ours.
And Rome, and London.
And Disneyland, eh?
Tomorrow we will be leaving here, and we will be able to be doing anything we are wanting to do. Anytime we are wanting to do it.
Here is to time.
Here's to Newsweek!
But what are we to be doing now with other guests?
Other guest? It's simple. It's to be being as easy to kill two people as to kill one. You are only needing another bullet.
Here's two bullets!
Two bullets!
The song of Mother Russia, I hear.
Stopping. Look, you think we could have a ride?
Please.
We're in a hurry. These people are chasing
us
with guns. They're shooting at us.
Please.
Well, what do you say? Can we have a ride?
Yeah, we can give you a ride.
Oh, great. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks
a lot for the ride, guys.
Yeah, thanks.
Appreciate it. It's take you up on the beers, but we gotta run.
Yeah.
All right.
Bye.
Damn, she's a fine-looking woman. Smell good, too.
Put your dick back in your pants. Come on, Wayne.
Marvelous things for me.
I'm sure. But you have all of these powers within yourself. The wand is just a crutch, a feather which you don't need to fly.
Please, you've dragged me all the way out here.
We won't discuss it anymore. No more wand. It's for your own good. Now, I'm going to place this wand over here, and I want you to repeat after me. Goodbye, old wand. Hello, new me.
Careful with that. It might go off.
Yes. Now say, goodbye, old wand.
Careful!
Yeah. Did you see that? That was
amazing.
Amazing, yeah.
But do you think you can make it work?
Well, only one way to find out.
American boy. This was easier than I thought.
What is for funny stick?
It's better, huh? It's just like Minsk.
You are not to be sexing me many times, Ivan.
All-American boy! I'm having something I think you will want. I think we should talk, huh? And keep that magic stick where I can see it. Hello, Mr. All-American boy. I am liking that magic stick. You are laying it down and I will let your friend go.
No. You let her go first, then I'll give you the stick.
No, first you lay down the stick, then the girl.
No. First the girl, and then the stick.
No, first you lay down the stick.
No, give...
Zap him!
Bob, you have a call on line 2.
Alice, there's something that I have to... Well, let me show you.
So you see, Steve, this whole thing about your strength and the anti-radiation and even the plans was all a fraud. Oh, I wouldn't use that particular word. It's more like effective public relations during a fundraising drive.
You were going to rip off the university.
Don't worry, you would have gotten a cut.
And I suppose you invented the mad bomber, too.
Oh, no, that's something entirely different. Why, he went berserk last week and blew up 3 shopping malls. Even money doesn't condone something that barbaric.
Oscar, I still can't believe it. I was more intelligent. I did run faster.
It's all in your mind, Steve. Of course, the drugs helped, but I wouldn't take too many more of them if I were you. We discovered that one of the side effects is tremendous constipation. Oh, cheer up, Steve. You're still a big hero to a lot of people. This country needs heroes. Used to be this country was full of heroes. But that was a simpler time when people had those honest, genuine values that we've come to associate with freedom and justice and individuality and Chevrolet and apple pie and the Super Bowl and democracy and anti-communism and heterosexuality and virginity.
Sorry, Mr. Timmon. They did say everything had to go.
Mom.
Steve, come on. I'm taking you away from here. You have ruined my boy.
I have done no such thing.
You have. His university has. I knew he should be an auto mechanic, but his father says no, no. Maybe he'll be a great surgeon someday. Come on, Steve.
You've got it all wrong, Mrs. Awesome. I stand for the virtues that made this country great. Individual initiative, free enterprise, business, advancement, ice hockey.
Yes, ice hockey. One of the many sports you'll enjoy at the proposed Tinman Winter Lodge and Fallout Shelter. With construction scheduled for early next year, there's still room for a few far-sighted investors who see the important place of recreation in our post-nuclear future. Visit our genetic spa. Soar down the slopes in your lead-lined ski suit. Don't worry about depleted ozone. We have our own supply. At the new Tinman Lodge, survival is our business.
Committee for correct punishment.